Final speaker for the day, we have with us Professor Dr. G. Nagabhushan Sir, Principal, Shandigiri Ayurveda Medical College, Palakkad. Sir completed his BAMS from Dr. B.R.K.R. Ayurveda College, Hyderabad in 2002 and MD in Manovignan Eva Manasarog from Vaidyaratnam P.S. Warrior Ayurveda College, Kottakkal in 2006. Sir is the member of International Journal of Ayurveda and Alternative Medicine and chief editor of monthly newsletter of Shandigiri Ayurveda Medical College. Sir has also been a resource person for many national and international seminars, CMEs, as well as delivered radio talks on Ayurveda for public health. Sir has wrote a book on endometriosis, an Ayurvedic view, and has awarded with the best thesis in the thesis competition conducted by Vaidyaratnam Aushadhashala on pitfalls in Ayurvedic medical educational system and ways and means to correct it. Sir was also honored with award from Nagarjuna Herbal Concentrations Limited, Jivaga Award from Himalaya Drug Company, Dabur Ayurmeda Award and Award of Excellent Performance in First Junior Course in Sanskrit, Hyderabad. So we kindly request you to continue with the presentation. Over to you, sir.
Om Idam Namaha Gurubhyah Purvajebhyah Purvebhyah Adhikrutbhyah Gunatraya Vibhedena Murtitraya Mupeyushe Trayi Bhuve Trinetraya Triloki Pataye Namaha. Om Namah Shivaya. In between, if I get disconnected, please, Sunil sir, if you are there, please call me because sometimes it is getting disconnected.
Sorry, sir, your slides are not visible.
Slides are not visible?
No, sir. Yes, sir, it's visible.
Visible?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, thank you. In between, if I get disconnected, please call me. Sunil, sir, if you are there, or Murli, sir. Respected Murli, sir. Respected Ramani,
sure.
Madam.
Sure.
Respected T.D. Srikumar, sir. Respected Shailama, Madam. And respected Anantalakshmi, Madam. And everyone who are there in this platform, and also teachers, my colleagues from my college and all over Kerala, all over India. And I thank organizers for conducting this webinar and inviting me to be the one of the resource person. My topic is Trigunas in the practice, in clinical practice. In this session, I'm going to present with the introduction, Trigunas in Ayurveda, relevance of these Trigunas in our clinical practice, and what is the scope of the practice, clinical practice, and the lacunas and incompleteness in contemporary practice, and ways to make it complete, and at the last, to conclude. And coming to the introduction, everything is Gunamaya. This total cosmos is nothing but the evolution from the gunas, and that was explained very beautifully by Murli sir previously and yesterday's speaker also. And even Ayurveda also, it is explained, that is vikara jatam vividham treen guna nati vartate. So this jagat is, it cannot go beyond these three gunas. And vikara jata vishwarupena avasitam sattvarajastama amsi na vyatirichate. This is told by Acharya Sushruta. And the same is described in even Bhagavad Gita also. Nata dasti prativyam va deveshu vapunaha sattvam prakriti jair mukta yadi satribir gunaihi. So this total cosmos is made up of trigunas. And whatever today we are discussing and whatever today we are experiencing, everything is nothing but the trigunas itself. Our terminology may be different, but whatever we are doing, it is due to the gunamaya, that is due to the trigunas itself. And all sciences and systems are also nothing but they are the outcome of the gunas itself. Whether it is modern system or Ayurveda system, whether it is chemistry or physics, whatever it may be. Whatever the differences are there, all these differences are also due to the gunas itself. Whether knowingly or unknowingly, we are practicing gunas and its derivatives. That is like in Ayurveda, in our philosophical sciences, we are having sattva, rajas, tamas and its derivatives. In modern, we are having something, metabolism and different enzymes, hormones and systems, etc. But whatever it may be, they are nothing but they are made up of the gunas itself. And coming to the practicing these gunas, where we have to practice, for whom we have to practice, whether this practice should be for ourselves or others. Actually, the practicing of gunas should be for ourselves first, and later we have to practice for others. Though Ayurveda is having embedded in these guna theory and its practical aspects, present day Ayurveda is not yet explored it in its the maximum potential. And each treatment modality has its area and interrelated to each other. Because whatever evolved so far, whatever the sciences are there, all they are nothing but these trigunas itself. And in Sankhya, we have gone through the evolution. Depending upon the evolution, depending upon the stage, the particular theories, otherwise particular treatment protocol is implemented there. For example, even in Ayurveda itself, we are having three types of treatment modalities. That is, for the Nijarogas, we are having Yukti Vipashaya and Daivi Vipashaya, and other one is the Sattvavajaya Chikisa. And even Yukti Vipashaya, we cannot apply everywhere. Daivi Vipashaya Chikisa, we cannot apply everywhere. And Sattvavajaya Chikisa also, we cannot apply everywhere. Each treatment modality, modality is having its own area to be applied. And why it is so? Because evolution is like that. It is not like everyone is at the one level, and whatever the conditions are, whether health or whether it is disease, all they are not at the single point, but they are having different levels of evolution, different levels of modification. And as per that modification, whichever is needed there, we have to, that the treatment modality has to be applied. Not only this Ayurveda, even we are having this Jyotisha is there. From by the Jyotisha, we can do mantra is there, tantra is there. So all they're having their own, even Reiki treatment is also there, like pranic healing is also there. All they're having their own, like if someone is having some thorn in his foot, we cannot go for a Reiki treatment. There is no need. Why we have to do it one? Because we can just remove it with a needle, isn't it? And like that, the role and the area where these, whether it is physiology or pathology, that has to be understood, and such type of treatment has to be delivered. And that beauty is due to this trigunas. That's why all sciences are mutually related. And this can be understood only that person who understands this universe as it is. And that was possible, and that was made by our acharyas, our aptas, who could visualize everything. Because if you go for compartmentalization, and you can go further, and where you can reach, nowhere you can reach. But there are some common properties are there. If you are able to understand those common properties as well as the special properties, then this universe can be understood, as madam also told, that is andanda and pindanda. And if we could understand this properly, and we can, and that's why these gunas are having very much importance. Like madam told, in America or somewhere, they are not having this triguna awareness, still they are doing many things. Yes, because whether you are aware of it or not, and you can give any name, nomenclature may be differing, but in essence, all these are nothing but the trigunas. And in Ayurveda, we know Sharirendra Sattvatma Samyogo Dhari Jivitam. And in this one, Sattva Atma Sharira, I am not going in detail. Atma is Nirvikara and it is Gunatita, whereas Sattva is gunatmaka, trigunatmaka, and sharira is guna janya, and it is of panchabhautika. That is evolution. What I want to say is this is evolution. That is sharira is panchabhautika, whereas sattva is trigunatmaka, atma is gunatita, and that's why atma is not a abode for the disease and health. It is nirvikara. But sattva and sharira, they are the abode for health as well as the disease conditions. And that dynamic nature, whether it is physiology or pathology, it is happening due to these trigunas and their modifications. That's why it is called as tachadikaranam srutam. For the treatment, it is the adhikarana. Vedasya satadharamhi vedoyam stamprakashitaha. So it is adhikarana because it is trigunatmaka. That's why it is told as adhikarana for our Ayurveda. As just now I have told, in Sushrutacharya, he said, Sattvarajastamamsi na vyatirichyante vikara jata vishwarupena avasthitam. So whatever the things existing in this cosmos, they are one way or other way, directly or indirectly, they are related to this Sattvaraja and Tamas. And that is, even in Vata Pitta Kapha, what we say, our Tridoshas, they are also related and derived from these three gunas itself. And when it comes to the Acharya Charaka says, so I am Ayurveda Shashvito Nirdishyate, and the third reason for that one is bhava swabhava nityatvacha. Bhava swabhava nityatva, that is whatever that we are dealing with, stavara jangamatmaka dravyas are there, they are those qualities they are possessing are nitya. And Ayurveda is based on these nitya qualities of this bhava swabhava. That's why Ayurveda is shashvata. So what makes this bhava swabhava nityatva? It is due to these trigunas. And unless until we understand these trigunas in this bhava dravyas and their swabhava and how they are nityatva, then only we can understand what actually Ayurveda is. And dhatu samakriya chokta. Here, what is the dhatu? Chakrapani says dhatavo vatadayo rasadayasya tatha rajaha prabhrutayasya. So dhatu means generally in Ayurveda, in our discussion we say it is only rasadi dhatus. It is not so. Dhatus are also raja, tamas and sattva. We have to understand. And when our dhatu samya kriya, when we keep all these things in our mind, then only the dhatu samya can be possible. And Murli sir already told, that is, what is actually guna? He very beautifully explained. It is not, guna means not like properties or something. It is guna, they are nothing but the constituents or energies. The best word to translate guna is constituents or energies. Because even Bhagavan, Shankara Bhagavatpara Vada says, that is gunaha iti paribhashikaha shabdaha. Na rupadivat dravyashritaha gunaha. So it is only technical term used there, guna, as Sar told. It is gauna to the purusha, that's why they are told as guna. It is not like the guna that we have definition. Even whether it is Ayurveda, it is so. As I told, that is vikara jatam vividham trin guna nati vartate. In that one, Sarvanga Sundara Vyakhya says, here guna means sattvarajastamaha sangnyan. There the word used is sangnya. It is only paribhashika shabda. That's why here guna means they are not the gunas, that is 41 gunas or other gunas, dvandvas are there. It is not like that. They are actually the constituents of this cosmos. They are the energies of this evolution. And okay, I am not going in depth. This last one is, that is, trigunas are all pervasive and continuous because whatever the tendencies that we are having, they are produced as thoughts at the mano level, and those same thoughts are expressed outside as actions. So tendencies are there, thoughts are there, actions are there. In other words, we can say we have three shariras, that is sukshma sharira and stula sharira, karana sharira. The tendencies they are there in the karana sharira, and the thoughts are there in the sukshma sharira and stula sharira, they are expressed as actions. Now, when Ananta Lakshmi Madam, after her presentation, whether we are doing all these things, whether we are having all these emotions due to the structure of the brain, otherwise any whether brain is changing as per our needs, that we have to understand, because it is not like that brain is having those centers, that's why we are doing all these things. It is actually we are having those tendencies as per the tendencies their in neurons, their connections are taking place, changes are taking place, and they are expressed outside as actions. And because if we say any structural entity is a cause for expressing all these things, then there cannot be any further development for an individual. Otherwise, we need not do all these samskaras. What is the need of these samskaras? That's why it is the karana sharira tendencies. For another example, I can say, Google Meet is there. If we are presenting or doing our presentation in Google Meet, the options are different. If there is phone, any smartphone is there. Even among the smartphones, depending upon the company, and it is the options are varying. So there may so tendencies that we are having inherently. Otherwise, the tendencies that are as per our samskara we are having, these tendencies are getting as thoughts, and these thoughts are coming out as actions. And as per the need, whatever the anatomical and physiological structures and functions are there, all they may be changing as per our tendencies, that we have to understand. And whether gunas and doshas, we know that is these three are called as gunas, whereas rajas and tamas are called as doshas. The reason we know very well, already explained. And here the third point I want to highlight, that is niyatastu anubandho rajas tamasoho parasparam nahi arajas kaha tamaha pravartate. This word is clinically very important, because anubandha rajastamas are niyataha tu anubandho rajastamas, they go hand in hand alone, they cannot work, because sattva is there unless until sattva is getting covered, these rajas and tamas cannot dominate. So what happens, this tamas is going to cover the sattva and rajas is going to act on it, and otherwise, they cannot do it, because due to the sattva, that is, sattvam is, it is shuddham, adosham, akhyatam. Due to the shuddhatva, in presence of sattva, this cannot do. That's why rajas and tamas are there, and nahi arajaskam tamaha pravartate. So whenever, that's why in clinically also, whenever we are going to deal any case, we have to take care of this one. Next, stress, eustress, and distress. And these states are there in stress is there. This total, that is from avyakta, when everything has emerged out, it is due to the stress emerged out. We are living, we are dying. Again, we are going to live. Again, we are going to die. This total chakra, this cycle is happening due to the stress. When there is no stress, avastha where without stress can be possible, when we get the moksha, up to that one there will be stress, and the level of stress and the types of stress, that makes the difference whether it is eustress or distress. Sattva is eustress in the level of sattva, because sattvam sukhe sanjayati rajah karmani bharata jnanam avrutte tu tamah pramade sanjayatyuta. That is explained in Bhagavad Gita, very beautiful sloka. That is, whatever the cognition process is taking place, it is under the background of this triguna, and as per the dominance of the guna, this total cognition process is going on. Not only cognition, even metabolism also. Whatever the, for example, immunity system is there, otherwise each organ is functioning. Why it is functioning? For what sake it is functioning? For whom it is functioning? And it is the karana is the ahankara, that is, it is me. For me, I am working, I am doing all these things. That ahankarika tattva is coming out of these three gunas. Okay. Yeah. And which type of sangha we are which type of sangha is taking place? That is ahankara. Which type of ahankara is taking place? That is when there is sattva is there, that is sukha sangena badhnati. Whereas let me directly go to the clinical practice. In our clinic, in a clinical setup, there is a prameha rogi coming and he is having strong desire to have day sleep as well as sweets, etc. And how we can control this patient, how we can say what to be done, what not to be done. We may be giving many drugs, etc., medicines, etc., but to the patient to be follow this avoiding day sleep and having the pathya diet, what he has to do. He's if you advise him also, he may not be able to follow you. Then what we have to do? There, only this that is Yukti Vyapasya Chikitsa is not going to act there. And there is also another case, a case of substance abuse, where otherwise alcohol abuse, where patient is unable to restrain. We can advise them, you should not take alcohol, you should not take any drug, etc. But patient is unable to restrain him, abstain from those drugs. Then what we have to do? Here, we know, Madhya Prasangam Tam Chagnya Mahadosha Mahagadam Sukamithya Vigachanti Rajo Moha Parajitaha Madhyopahata Vijnana Viyukta Satvikair Gunaihi Shreyobhir Viprayujyante Madanda Madalala Saha. So it is very beautifully, stage by stage, one becomes addicted to the madhya, that is drug substance is explained here. That is in initial stages, patient may be taking due to the friends, etc., when they compel him, but without knowing that this is Mahadosha and Mahagada, what he is doing, he is Sukamithya Vigachanti Rajomoha Parajitaha. Due to this Rajas and Tamas, he is getting addicted to it. And Madhyopahata Vijnana Viyukta Sattvika Irgunaihi, when he is getting addicted to it, then whatever the Sattvika Gunas he was having, he is completely devoid of the Sattvika Gunas. Ultimately, Shreyobhir Viprayujyante Madanda Madalalasa. So these are the various stages in which these gunas are getting deranged, getting changed. So at the same time, when we want to treat, manage such type of cases, we have to understand the pathology at the guna level. Then only we can manage that. In the same way, a case of somatoform disorder. Even in general practice also, we will be getting many somatoform disorders. The patients who are coming with pain, otherwise some pain, otherwise some burning sensation, etc. Then if you go to any allopathic modern doctor, what they will be doing, they will be doing many tests, etc. And they say there is no pathology at all. But when they come to our clinical, in that one, generally the advice is tikshanasya, yaha sakto shuddhasya achara vibhramshe, tikshanam navana manjanam, that is prescribed there. And for this tikshanasya, etc., that is Shallakoloka Marjara, Jambuka Vrushabhasta Jaihi, etc., etc. Mutra Pitta Shakrulloma Nakai Charma Bhirevaja, Sekanjanam Prathamanam Nasyam Dhumam Chakarayet, etc. That is the one of the yoga described. You see, here Mutra Pitta Shakrulloma, etc. Yeah, Triguna in clinical practice. Mutra Pitta, Shakruloma, etc. And if you analyze at the guna level, actually we can say that they are actually amedhya. But in that particular condition, they are needed. So the treatment sometimes when the patient is, that is in hallucinatory behavior, the patient is losing his total, no insight at all. In that condition, tikshna nasya we have to give. And by which patient, it is actually a specialty case. That's why I'm not going in detail. Of apparent, no apparent nidana sevana, we are getting such patients. Actually, if you try to get the such relevant nidana for that particular disease. And that, in the same way, a case of definite nidana sevana, but no apparent disease condition, how it is occurring there? Acharyas are explained, that is drushtapacharjah kashchit kashchit purvaparadhajah tat sankarat bhavatyanyo vyadhirevam tridha smritah. So here drushta doshottah and karmajottah dosha karmajah rogas are there. And to understand how these doshas are getting next janma, next how it is happening, what are the vehicle it is happening, it is aiding in that one, as already told, because we are having linga sharira and sukshma sharira and sthula sharira, whatever the deeds that we did, and sometimes with this karana sharira, sukshma sharira, they are getting in the next janma, isn't it? So such type of understanding can be possible, otherwise we cannot manage properly. If it is karmaja vyadhi, then the patient has to, till that karma phala is getting vented out, we have to wait. And we had to understand that when this knowledge is very essential, and such type of transforming from one generation to the another generation, it can be possible by only understanding this three gunas. In the same way, a case of suicidal thoughts and suicidal attempts. Why one person is committing suicides? Why one person is having these suicidal thoughts? Actually, as I told, it is due to the tamas. Actually, the urge behind these suicidal thoughts and attempts are nothing but to get out of the distress. But when tamas is getting avarana to the sattva completely, and there due to the rajas, one is committing suicides. If we are able to control that patient, otherwise stop those some 3-4 seconds, can be saved. So this mechanism has to be understood. And in the one of the case of like Vishamajwara, when patient is suffering from in 2 days back, the news, it was there. Whenever August 9 and 10 comes, there is distress among the people of Idukki district. Why? For last 3 consecutive years, whenever August 9th and 10th, there is flooding, and the destruction due to the excessive flooding is happening. So such type of mechanisms, when such type of cues they are getting, such experiences they are getting, then there will be stress. And how we can, because only by vata vita kapha, we cannot treat such type of cases. There we have to understand, like in upaya, vismruti has to be done. How that vismruti can be done, and the various ways of vismruti we have to understand in the setup of these trigunas. In the same way, pandemics and distress, already Anantarashmi Madam explained them. And the trigunas and their applied aspects can be understood in dinacharya, rutucharya. Though dinacharya, rutucharya we can explain on the basis of vata pitta kapha, but to understand completely, and we have to go beyond this vata pitta kapha and at the triguna level. How, I will explain later, like patya patya sevana, it is also one of the indriya vijaya there we are getting. Otherwise, like anya janmas also, those nidana sevana phala can be transferred, like sadvrutta. Okay, you know, one by one, like psychotherapy, whatever the behavior, cognitive behavior therapy is there, behavior therapy is embedded behind all these therapies are nothing but these trigunas. And here we have to understand, scope of a science need not be a limitation for an adhikari. That is, generally we say, in Ayurveda, bhutobhyo hi param yasmat nasti chinta chikitsite. So we have to, because loka dvaividya, that doesn't mean that as an Ayurveda person we should not go beyond these triguna, beyond these panchamaha bhuta theory. And to be able to understand this total pathological conditions, physiological conditions, we have to even go beyond these, and the science should not become a limitation for our understanding. You see, in Agantuja Rogas, when explains the Graha Rogas, Acharya says, Samasa Dinacharya Adi Prokta Chara Vatikramaha. So, for the Bhutadi, etc., for their affliction, this the, whatever the Acharas, Dinacharya, Charyas are explained in Ayurveda, they are having their own role. And this role is not limited to only just Vata Pitta Kapha, but it goes beyond these Vata Pitta Kaphas at the psychological level, at the Buddhi level, at the Sukshma Sharira level, and at the Linga Sharira level. Okay. In the same way, Manasa Punaha, Istasya Alabhat, Labhatya Anistasya. In another way of this one is Istasya Labhat. There Acharya Chakrapani says, Istasya Labhat, that is, what are the pathological conditions there it is happening, that is kama harishadayaha. Istasya labhat, kama harishadayaha are getting generated. And anistasya labhat, that is shokadayaha. That's why whenever we get something we long, there also we are getting some psychological distress. And whenever we are unable to get what we desire, there also there is psychological distress. So to get away from this psychological distress, we have to go to the sattva level. Okay. Another example is manasa vyadhi paritena api sata buddhya hita hitam aveksha aveksha dharmartha kama ana. Ahitanam anupasevane hitanam cha upasevane. People disorders are aveksha, dharmartha kamanam, those which are ahita, which we have to avoid them, and which are good for our health, we have to indulge in them. Okay. We know triguna, three causes for the kalata karmanam yogo hinam idhyati matrakaka. This is even applicable for both physical disorders as well as the mental disorders also. Those common factors are there, and that commonality is due to these three gunas. There, sadvruta, why we have to have this sadvruta? Tasmad atmahitam chikirshata sarvena sarvam sarvada smutimasthaya sadvruttam anushteyam. So for all beings, this sadvruta is advocated. The importance is, that is, sampadayati arthadvayam arogyam indriya vijayam cheti, the physical and mental health that we are going to get. And I'm not going in depth of this sadvruta, because actually in text it is there, but we have to understand properly how we set up. Okay, but for that one, the process has to be understood by us. That's why I'm not going in depth. In books it is there, you go through it, but we have to understand that it is not only just for Vata Pitta Kaphas, this is sadvruta or dinacharya are prescribed. Okay, and at the guna level also we have to understand. That's why ahara achara cheshtasu sukharti prety chehaja param prayatnam atishthet buddhiman hitasevane. For what sake? Sukha sukharti pretya cha ihaja, for this world and the world beyond, to get the good result achara cheshtasu, that is in sadruta we have to. And very beautifully explained by Charaka Acharya in Charaka Sharira, how this world of attachment and detachment are taking place. Why I am saying this one is because being we Ayurvedic persons, being the Ayurvedic students and teachers, we are unable to understand what Acharyas to some sutrasthana, nidanasthana, and chikisasthana. In between indriyasthana, sharirasthana, whatever they explained, it is for our better understanding. Otherwise, we cannot do justice. We cannot do our clinical practice at the best, unless until pravruti hi, there is no time. Otherwise, there are various how this attachment is taking place, and how we can get out of this attachment. What are the process of this detachment? Yes, detachment is also needed for our best. That is explained in Krishna and Moksha. That is Upadha, Naishtiki Chikitsa. Naishtiki Chikitsa, it is very beautifully explained. Upadahi paro hetu dukkha dukkhasya pradaha tyagaha sarvopadhanam. So there, how it is happening? Koshakaro yadahyam upadate vadapradhan. Due to our desires, etc., that is Icha Desha Atmika Krishna Sukha Dukkha Pravartate, Krishna Cha Sukha Dukkha Nam Karanam Punaruchyate. So these are the cycles, and when we are able to find this total process and go beyond this one, then only we can understand human personality as it is. Otherwise, there will be limitations and misunderstandings. That is one of the example is how one preceptor should be there. That is Buddhi Smriti Jnana Tapo Nivasa Punarvasu Prana Bhutam Sharanyaha. In every chapter of Chikisasthana, the greatness of Punarvasu Atreya are described. It is not just for description, but whenever we are going to deal any pathological condition, first of all we have to be devoid of that pathological condition, then only we can do justice. Person suffering from Kushta, whether he can treat the Kushta Rogi, person suffering from Prameha, can treat a Prameha, because unless until he himself cannot cure by his own thoughts, his own learning, he cannot do justice for others. So that completeness can be possible. The relation in between psyche and soma, shariram hevi sattvam anu vidhiyate sattvam cha shariram. That is in elaborately madam has explained there, that is psychoneuro endocrinology, how it is taking place. There sattvika 7 kayas are there, rajasika 6 kayas and tamasika 3 kayas are there. That is brahma sattva to the gandharva sattva. That is sattvika kayas are there. And it indicates that this human body is, this human birth is an media. It is a media by which even we can uplift ourselves to the Brahma Sattva and at the Tamasika, that is Pashu, Masya, Vanaspati Sattva. We can be like a Vanaspati, that is like a plant kingdom. So, if we put efforts, we can reach up to the Brahma Sattva. We can even downgrade ourselves by doing which are forbidden things, and then we can even reach to the Vanaspati Sattva. And it is up to us how we try to uplift ourselves. And other principles of this Trigunas are the Kama Shoka Bhaya Krodha Harshesha Lobha Sambhavan Paraspara Pratidandha Irebireva Shamam Nayet. You see, these are the various manasika bhavas. It is actually, these are avastika chikitsas. Depending upon particular avastha of the patient, these are upayas also. In other words, we can say that these are the upayas. So the person has to be subjected so that he can be away from that manasika bhava. It is not going to be a complete cure, but in that particular avastha, Krodha Jaro Nasham Krodha Kama Samudbhava in Jara Chikitsa, it is told. So these are the various manasika bhavas. That is how this sattva can be clinically we can utilize in Vyadhita Rupi Adhyaya. It is explained sattva dinam vikalpena Vyadhita Rupam Adhature. So atara, that sattva has to be understood, otherwise in our dosage, in understanding of the pathologic condition, there will be mistakes. And another thing is like Tairalpa Sattvasya, it is for the specialty I am saying. Tairalpa Sattvasya Mala Pradushta Buddhya Divasam Hudayam Pradushya. This is a samprapti of Unmada. In this one, the Unmada samprapti is taking place in a person who is having this Alpa Sattva. And by doing whatever the Unmada treatment procedures are there, where we are getting the patient, again we are bringing the patient to this alpasattva level, from that alpasattva level to the normalcy, we have to bring that patient to there. Only this panchakarma therapy, otherwise shodhana therapy, it is not going to work there. There we have to sattvavajaya chikitsa we have to do. And how this sattvavajaya chikitsa can be done? Whether it is a 1 day course, otherwise 15 day course, it is not so. It is a continuous process. Changing the sattva is a continuous process. Otherwise, by giving some panchabhautika dravya, if we could able to change anyone's sattva, we can do it. We could have done it. Because if we could do like that, there will be no any terrorist, there will not be any robber, there will not be any drug addict, there will not be any rapist, etc. But it never happens unless until you realize yourself that there is self motivation is there, we cannot change anyone. That's why even we will be getting some advertisement in the papers also for the drug addicts, you can give this medicine or that medicine. It is not going to work. Because there should be self-motivation. I have seen such many persons. If there is no self-motivation, you cannot help them. And by doing various, though indulging in other things which should not be indulged, and getting the pain, he will be getting out of, he realized today or tomorrow, and he will get out of that condition. And am I audible? Are you following me?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah. And how this, even before getting birth itself, the sattva has to be modified. And there are ways of, that is, sattva vaisheshakara bhavani, punas tesham tesham pranina, matru pitru sattvani, antarvartnya, shrutayasya abhikshnam, sochitam cha karma, sattva vishesha abhyasascheti. So, even in the garbhashaya, when that one is there, there itself, this sattva has, even not only that one, even during copulation itself, the manasika bhava of both parents should be very proper, then only the proper progeny can be possible. And we cannot make anyone scapegoat, because whatever is happening for us, we are responsible for it. Atmanam eva manyeta kartaram sukha dukkayoho. Tasmat Shreyaskaram Margam Pratipadyeta Notaset. And we have to take that responsibility. And we could, when we are able to take that responsibility, then only the Shreyas can be possible. And here, by doing Hrudindriya Shirakosha Samshuddhi Vamanadivihi, that is in Panchakarma therapies, it is in Unmada actually. But even whenever do proper Panchakarma, that is Manaprasadam Apnoti Smriting Sanyam Chavindati. Manaprasada is one of the quality. So that metabolism is getting corrected, not only at the dosha level, even at the manasika level also. Like one of the condition is there, samrodhyasya tamo gruhe yaha sakto avinaye pattaihi. Here one of the nahi arajaskam tamaha pravartate, that principle is applied here. When the patient is completely having dominance of rajas, there we are putting the patient in the tamogruha, by which even the external stimuli are going to make the person disturb. That's why Acharya says that you have to put the patient in the tamogruha, by which the external stimuli can be come to the normalcy. This is one of the principles. And tarjanam prasanam danam harshanam santvanam bhayam vismayo vismuteer hetu nayanti prakriti manaha. These are various upayas, techniques Acharya describe depending upon the condition. These are the conditions. Deha dukkha bhayo bhayi param prana bhayam sutam. There the concept of this abhinivesha comes, where in yoga shastra we are having. Because each individual, each living being always tries to avoid the death. And in this process, that is deha dukkha bhayo bhayi param prana bhayam sutam. When the person is like, it is one of the treatment modality. I think if we could apply that one, patient is getting out of that pathological condition. And I request all the viewers, just you mark yourself, know your sattva when it is needed, in whether you believe in the holy and pious people, otherwise wealthy and the powerful, otherwise the goons. If you need any help, whom you to whom you go and ask the help, whether the holy persons are pious, wealthy and powerful, or goons. You mark yourself. If it is one, you put 1, 2, 3. And the second one is the food you like the most, whether juicy, sweet dishes, preparations of ghee, milk and fruits, salty, that is excessive salty, sour, pungent and masala preparations. Third one is foul smell, stale, leftover or impure food. In the same way, the next slide, the purpose of sacrifices you do. Whether the sacrifice, driving principle behind that sacrifice is without any expectations in return, expecting something in return, otherwise out of compulsion. And the next one is the motive of self-restraint, why you are restraining yourself, whether it is volitional, if there is desire, is there something you want to do, if you are unable to do, whether it is due to the volitional, otherwise for self-projection, and for harming others and with mean intentions. The E, the charity you do is for what sake you are doing this charity. It is whether it is as a duty to be done with some expectations in return, otherwise out of compulsion. And the next one is, the next slide, the world in your view is universal outlook as one with me, otherwise everything is different from one another. Self-centric importance, whether you are the only one living in this world. And the G, the purpose of your actions, why you are doing all these things without any attachment, otherwise expecting some selfish gains for doing this one, and whether it is out of ignorance, without doing without any direction, without any knowledge, you are doing it. And you put yourself the marks, and you see, if you are getting 7 and you are completely sattva person, if you are getting 14 marks, you are complete rajasa, and if you are getting 21, you are complete tamasa person. And no one will be like staying at 7 or 14 or 21. In between only everyone will be there. Okay. And you assess yourself what you are. And if you are really, and you also ask nearby who knows you better, and ask them to rate you, how many marks you get. And both are matching, then really you are that sattvika person. If they are, because there are many things you don't want to put yourself in the rajasa or tamasa nature. That's why there will be bias. If you are unbiased, definitely you are a sattva person, and you can you yourself. And lastly, I want to conclude, and I want to say something regarding the importance of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. It is actually a practical guide. All individuals should go through it, because it is a Bhagavad Gita is a situation, it is a life, a real situation where we are confused and there is indecisive in nature, and we are biased what to do, what not to do, we are unable to do. If we want to come out of such situations, and by going through this Bhagavad Gita, their teachings, we can come out of it, because it is not a philosophy, because it is having comprehensive details on physical, mental, psychological, intellectual, social and spiritual fears, and it integrates everything and leads one beyond this phenomena. And the Bhagavad Gita, these are the 13 aspects of mental being explained in the form of, that is, 3 types of Shraddha, 3 types of Ahara, 3 types of Yajna, 3 types of Tapas, Dana, Tyaga, Jnana, Karma, Karta, Buddhi, Dhriti, Sukha, and as per our Dharma, what karmas we have to do. So it encompasses everything, social, spiritual, physical, mental, everything it covers. So we should go through it. You see, at the time of death, as per our psychology, what can be our next birth and what can be the expressions there, that is explained, as we can assess ourselves what actually faith we are having, because these are not the test means scales as such, but these are the pathways by which we can attain to the sattvika level. Yajante sattvika devan yaksha rakshamsi rajasaha. So if we are doing this, we are having faith in Yaksha Raksha, that is in gundas, otherwise politicians who are not having good conduct, then we have to change ourselves. We have to put our faith in some of the good person, Sathvika. That is how we can uplift ourselves regarding Ahara. It is yesterday and today also explained. And sacrifices, that is Yajna, how you are doing and how we can do it. In Dharaniya Vegas, it is nothing but the tapas. Because here, this sloka is very important. Karmendriyani samyamya ya aste manasasmaran indriyarthan vimudhatma mithyacharah sa uchyate. And if we are unable to restrain ourselves and all these things, then we are called mithyachara. And ultimately what happens? We lead ourselves into the destruction. There will not be any upliftment for us. So these 13 aspects are there. As per that 13 aspects, if we can understand ourselves and also others, then definitely there will be no pathological conditions. And one of the most misunderstood concept is dharma and karma. That is, as per our dharma, we have to do karma. That is, shamo damastapaha shaucham shantirarjavam evacha jnanam vijnanam astikyam brahma karma swabhavajam. If we are having this brahma, that is brahma sattva, and if we are unable to do such karmas, it is going to give many distress conditions. At the same time, if you are having kshatra personality, but you want to do something brahma karmas, then there will be many problems. Sattva, if they are indulging something which is not suitable for them, then naturally there will be many problems in our professional life. To get out of that one, if someone is approaching you, you have to understand which dharma and whether that profession is suitable. Out of compulsions, they may be doing such type of professions, but it is going to give many problems. Okay, in coming to the last, concluding. In research and education also, in research nowadays, the driving principle is the, I think, paisa itself. But actually, the driving principle should be unbiased, and it should be for the well-being of all beings. Then only the actual research can be done. We can see that when that principle is not behind such type of research, what happens? For the sake of some gain, we will be doing, and which is that is in modern allopathy pharmacy, we are coming across, so we are able to witness it. And at the same time, education also. Acharya says, Vidya samaptau brahmam va sattvam ashamathapi va dhruvam avishati jnanat tasmat vaidyo dvijasmrutaha. You see, if you are really vidya samaptau, if really there is vidya samapta, actually what should be the change? Brahmam va sattvam arsham va. Arshisattva, otherwise Brahmasattva should be there. Dhruvam avishyati, Acharya is saying, definitely we are going to do. But whether we are getting that one, we have to introspect ourselves. And lastly, I want to say, and why this gap is there? It is due to the lack of information, education and communication. That is, there should be proper information, education and communication, otherwise whether in our clinics, otherwise in our education, otherwise in our own personal life, properly information, education, communication should be there. Otherwise, what happens? Prakrite kriyamanani gunahi karmani sarvashah ahankara vimudhatma kartaham iti manyate. Actually, advesta sarvabhutanam maitraha karna evacha nirmamo nirahankara sukadhuk samadukha sukaksham. And we have to try our level best to bring others also into this stage. If we could pass that stage also, then we can have this state of asangoham, 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 punaha, punaha, sachidananda rupoham, ahameva, aham avyayaha. Whether it is for Ayurveda persons, it is needed. Ayurveda is only one of the profession, but personally, we have to integrate ourselves. When that integration is there, then only you can do justice to this human being. Okay, the last one, please show. Sarve bhadrani pashyantu, maa kashchit dukkha bhag bhavetu. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. With this presentation, I conclude my presentation. Thank you, organizers. Thank you, everyone, viewers. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, very much for covering all the aspects of Trigunas and its clinical aspects in your lecture. and also huge thanks for explaining all the terms with example and nicely correlation of sattva with stress, you stress and distress. Thank you, sir, so much.
So we have got some queries from our participants. So
let's any time for asking questions or discussion. I am Dr. Vinod Kumar.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. I congratulate Dr. Anandalakshmi for extraordinary, exceptional presentation in this subject with all modern aspects and very classical presentation of Dr. Nagabhushan also. I want to just two, three points here we have to discuss for clarification. One is, we have a dosha prakriti is there, which is from our janma itself, which can't be altered. Whether there is a triguna, this sattva rajas tama prakriti is also acquired from the janma, or whether we can alter this. And the next is, we attribute rajas for vada, tamas for kapha, and sattva for pitta. But in Prakriti Vivarana, when we go to that, Kapha seems to be more Sattva Guna. So how it comes? And Dr. Nagabhushan is very well talked about the Bhagavad Gita. It is, I also accept that it is not just a Mother Grandha, it is a science in so many things, especially in Manas, in Triguna, Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga is there, 14th chapter, in 17th chapter, very much described about the Sattva, Raja and Tamo Guna, and even how a person goes to an imbalance in Manas by in the second chapter, everything is there. But the thing is, how, whether the ahara have any role in this. Bhagavad Gita is very definitely saying in this. Sattva, Tattumala, Ravala, Tushna, Arutha, Shushka, Vidahivi, these are our Rajasa ahara or Rajasa Pragati people like, these are all things. These points also, I want to take your attention. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Whether dosha prakriti can be changed? There are there are structural aspects are there. Those structural aspects cannot be changed because they are fixed. But when it comes to the functional aspects, then the possibility is there.
Yeah.
We have come across the biography of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. As a Gopika Bhava, when he was having devotion towards Krishna, though the male Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, there were many changes, even breast was coming out, whatever the secondary sexual characters were there, they were completely gone. So even like that intense bhavana was there, that he was a Gopika, then everything changed, all the endocrine, whatever we say, everything changed and he got a stri bhava in him. So there is possibility, and I cannot say that physical, that is dosha prakriti is changed, but functions can be altered with our manasika bhavas. And yes, definitely manasika prakriti is always changeable. It is if you want to change, I already told. Next, vata pitta kapha sattva rajas tamas, I told you, sir. Sattva rajas tamas, from the sattva rajas tamas, everything evolved and with various combinations and permutations, etc. So in this panchabhautika loka and later divisions of vata pitta kapha, there is nothing we can say that it is sattva, otherwise it is rajas, otherwise tamas. It is only combination of all these things. But again, it is also a relative thing. That which we say that it is sattvika need not be always sattvika, as you said, because kapha, when it is in its pure form, it is actually ojas, it is sattvika in nature. In the same way, pitta, Also, Satvika, when it is physiologically functioning properly, and Vata is also Satvika due to the Akasha Tattva in it. So, but when the same can be become a Rajasika or Tamasika. Okay. So, no substance, no situation can be said that it is always Satvika. And the only exception is that is Ojas, Sattva, and Akasha. Decrease causes something pathological condition, otherwise their increase always gives something positive. Okay, next one, sir. Ahara, you said, isn't it? And you explained actually. Okay, thank you. And with this ahara also, we can again, I want to add one thing, that is, in our Indian sciences, there is nothing like vegetarian or non-vegetarian. Our ahara is classified as per Satvika, Rajasika, Tamasika, and where Jangara Mamsa is described. That doesn't mean that Ayurveda prescribes Mamsa, because in Madhyayo, Hitashi, Prayatashuchi, there actually Madhya Mamsa are in the same way. Acharya Rasayana also advised not to take. So, generally, Mamsa is not Satvika in nature, and that doesn't mean that all the vegetarian dishes are Satvika. So, that is Rasya, Snigdha, Sthira, Hridya, that quality should be there. Dr. Arya presented that though we say that milk and ghee are Satvika, they need not be always Satvika. Generally, they are Satvika, but if there is no proper Agni is not there, if we take excessive of ghee, otherwise milk, they become Tamasika in nature. So, I think this clarification is sufficient. He is satisfied. Thank you. Murali sir, Sri Kumar sir. Ella varaku nanni.